Okay, solve the equation. Here we have negative x plus 2 in parentheses, then minus 2x equals negative 2 times x plus 1 in parentheses. We're going to use a graphing technique to solve this. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the left side of the equation and make that a function. The right side of the equation, make that another function. And then we're going to graph each equation separately. Now, when you solve an equation, the left side has to equal the right side for the equation to be true. So basically, what you do is you graph each side as a function, and that point of intersection is where the left side equals the right side. So let's take a look. First, we're going to make the two functions. This left side, I will call f of x equals negative parentheses x plus 2, and then minus 2x. Then g of x. It's going to be the right side of the equation, or negative 2 times x plus 1 in parentheses. So looking for f of x equaling g of x, let's get the calculator. Okay, so for the calculator, I'm going to press y equals. And I'm going to make y1 f of x, so I'm going to enter negative sign, open parentheses, x plus 2, close parentheses, and then minus 2x, and then g of x is going to be y2, it's going to be negative 2, open parentheses, x plus 1, close parentheses. Okay, now let's take a look at the graph. And this is a colored calculator, so you can see each line is a different color. We can go back to y equals and see which one's which. So we want to know the point of intersection here for solving the equation. So I'm going to put second, and then F4, which is calc, and then intersection, which is number 5. And then the calculator, by default, if there are only two functions graphed, it'll pick the first one, the second one, and then calculate the intersection. So you hit enter for the first curve, enter for the second curve, and then it says to guess, you enter one more time. And the intersection, it's x equals 0, and y equals negative 2. So the point of intersection is 0, negative 2. That's really what we're looking for. Okay, now we're looking for the x value for solving the equation. We're looking at where the x's are equal, that's 0. So let's just verify this. What I'll do is I'll take the 0 and substitute in the original equation. So it'll be negative of 0 plus 2 minus 2 times 0 equals negative 2 times 0 plus 1. I'm just checking to see if 0 is the solution to the equation. So 0 plus 2 is 2. Leave the negative out in front. Negative of 2. And then negative 2 times 0, that just makes 0, so let's put plus 0 equals 0 plus 1 is 1, so it'll be negative 2 times 1. So we have negative times 2, which is negative 2, equals negative 2 times 1, which is negative 2. So that works. X equals 0 is the solution. So the process, once again, make f of x the left side of the equation, g of x the right side. Go ahead and graph it, and the x-coordinate of the intersection is your solution to the equation.